that awkward moment, right? Boarding queue stop, he said hello already. This is his chance to get to know each other, right?
We are joined at the London Rolling Film Festival with the gorgeous Faith Elizabeth. Welcome, Faith.
Thank you so much, Fan Carpet, for having me again.
And it's so nice to have you at the London Rolling Film Festival again. Your film, In Flight, was in competition tonight. It didn't win. I mean, shocking, but it was incredible.
But you know, the film that won was amazing. It was written by and produced by and directed by an amazing woman. It was called Beautify.
That was the audience award. The jury award was The Messenger.
Yes. The Messenger one, but do you know what? I really love Beautify. I thought it was a really beautiful film. And like coming tonight and seeing all these amazing films, like obviously I'm always going to be a big supporter of my own production In Flight, but the talent that was in the room tonight was incredible.
The actual, every single film had something really, really special. It was so difficult to make that decision. It really was. But your film was very well received by the audience tonight. Your character Scarlett was, you know, she's a lot of fun.
She is. She's so much fun to play, but also so much fun to watch as well. And I really enjoyed seeing her. So before we had a screening, which obviously was our private screening, which we had at the Virgin Money Lounge, whereas tonight was the first time we've seen it in like a public audience that have seen it. And I was really nervous, but we had such a good reception. We had so many people laughing and so many people enjoying it that I was really proud of my little production.
I think I liked it even more the second time round, actually.
Thank you.
It's like you see different nuances, different things, and actually the complexity of the story and the layers to it.
And there's like quite a lot written in the script that's really subtle as well, so I can't give it away. Again, I'm constantly forced with not being able to give it away, but
we do love a twist.
We do love a twist, and also there's some really interesting script things that when you watch it again, you obviously know what the twist is that's coming, so you see it sort of building up beforehand. Yeah,
absolutely. So you're also here with Yes She Can.
Yeah.
Obviously I've been out in Cannes with you supporting your project as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
So you are one of our amazing women on our She Squad. For the support.
Girls.
Yeah, Yes She Can was a project that I launched this year. It's a women empowerment project. It's a positive focused movement which is working to celebrate, inspire and empower women within the film industry. So we're specifically focusing on bringing women to Cannes and bringing a positive movement to Cannes, but we're also working with other film festivals like this film festival. I'm working together to basically bring, you know, some support, encouragement, inspiration, celebration. I mean, there's so many things that we're doing that it's hard to sum up in a really short...
Absolutely. And now you've even got your Spotlight campaign.
Yes. So
tell us a bit about that.
So She Spotlight is a section of our website where basically we're putting a spotlight on one particular woman. So at a time we'll have a different woman on our She Spotlight. Obviously they'll all be on there for you to look at as well. So the She Spotlight basically focuses on the achievements and the celebrations of a woman that we think is particularly inspirational. And obviously tonight I announced that Alida Pantan, who is the founder of the London Rolling Film Festival, shall be our first ever She Spotlight.
And very, very well deserved.
Absolutely.
My business partner, Alida. She's amazing, talented, and you know, you couldn't have picked a better person for your first face of that campaign.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, like one of the reasons we started the campaign was because I was so inspired by Alida, by you, by Natasha Marburger, by so many women, and I thought this is so inspirational to meet these women and to be inspired by them and to work harder and to achieve more and to aim higher because of them. And if I can open up those opportunities to other women within the industry so that other women can also feel that same level of inspiration by having these women around them, then how much stronger and more positive is it going to be? So Alida is one of the few women that actually really like properly inspired me. People talk about being inspired by somebody because they watched a film or they saw something, but genuinely you women have inspired me insane amounts to go from being an actress, which I love and I still act, to doing more, to producing, to running my own production company, to launching my Yes She Can project, to give those opportunities to other people as well.
Absolutely. It's all about taking control and kind of helping each other along the way as well. And I know it's not been easy for you at times. There's been a lot of challenges along the road, even with the Yes She Can campaign.
Yeah.
That, you know, it's, you just keep getting back up, rolling with the punches. And I think it's made you so much stronger as an actress and as a producer as well. And I commend you for that.
They say like what knocks you down makes you stronger. And like my motto has always been just have faith. I have it tattooed on me because I was at a particular time in my life where I really needed to hold on to the fact that you need to have faith in yourself and what you're doing. But I mean, this campaign especially, like this year itself has been quite difficult for me personally as well as professionally. I've had a few challenges I've been dealing with. But, you know, the actual Yes You Can launch, we've come against so much difficulties, and actually that makes me realise how much more we need it because of all the opposition that we're having and all the difficulties we're having.
Absolutely, and you're always so open and honest about your journey, which I think a lot of people, even myself at times, have been very, you know, you want to put your best foot forward and your best face forward and that, you know, perfect smile and everything's great.
Yeah.
And sometimes it's really not.
It's like, not. And like the way that I live and the way that I choose to live and the way that my social media is very honest, and I'm very open about things. And I think it can be difficult sometimes when you look at somebody else and you see that they're doing something and you assume it's easy because they make it out to be easy. And that's absolutely fine, that some people want to just put their best foot forwards and they just want to shine a spotlight on the amazing stuff that they're doing. Whereas the way that I've sort of come to be able to deal with it myself is to actually talk about the challenges.
And so it's very refreshing.
Thank you. Bless you. I love you so much.
We all love you here.
But the thing is, like, when we actually do start to talk about the difficulties on a real-time scale, you don't wait until you've achieved something before you talk about how hard it was. While we're in the middle of it, we're saying, this is what we're going through, this is what we're struggling with, this is the difficulties we're having. And actually, we find strength and inspiration, myself and also as a company.
And in each other. Yeah, absolutely. Because then you see people do rally around.
Yeah.
Even you had like a coffee campaign, buy me a cup of coffee.
Yes, we did. So we had a buy me a coffee campaign because we lost all investment due to somebody that was trying to sabotage our campaign. And so, yeah, we basically raised a lot of money. We used Facebook, and we found an amazing company on Facebook called Bossy Ladies, like Bossy. And they're an amazing company who rallied together to bring a huge amount of money to support our campaign. And again, on Facebook in general, we've had so much support from people as well. So,
well, you keep doing what you're doing because it's working.
Thank
and you're getting, you know, so much support and so much bringing communities together. And I feel like men, women, all of us, yes, we
absolutely
can, essentially.
Absolutely, definitely.
Yeah.
It's coming. Watch for it. It's coming.
Thank you so much, Faith.
Thank
nice
you.
To see
love you.
You.
Thank you. Thank you, Fan Carpet.
Thank you. And Alida, come and join us.
This is amazing.
The
woman.
She Spotlight. The first face of She Spotlight.
Thank
She's
you.
Amazing.
Thank you, Faith. That's absolute pleasure. You. I can't wait to get you on there as my first lady of inspiration.
I'm scared now.
Okay. No, you're fabulous.
All right. Thank you very much. We need to
leave. Thank you so much. I'll go see. What?
Thank you for watching The Fan Carpet. If you like this video, be sure to click that thumbs up button at the bottom of your screen. And also be sure to subscribe to The Fan Carpet YouTube channels. They're absolutely free and so much fun too. Be sure to check out the official website, thefancarpet.com. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to stay up to date with reviews, competitions, the latest news, and so much more.